Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video I will cover objective mechanical part 7, fluid mechanics and thermodynamics part I will cover. This is useful for NHPC JEE, UPPSC, UPSSC and SSC JEE and for all other state PSC exams. Question is, one stroke is equal to stroke is unit of kinematic viscosity, it's equal to dynamic viscosity, coefficient of dynamic viscosity by density rho. One stroke equal to 1 cm² by second. A is your correct answer. And SI unit is meter square per second, CGS unit is centimeter square per second, and one stroke 1 cm² by second. Conversion and meter square per second relation with stroke is also important. So we will convert meter square per second equal to 10 to the power 4 centimeter square per second or 10 to the power 4 stroke. So one stroke equal to 10 to the power minus 4 meter square per second. This one also very important. Next question, poise is the unit of coefficient of dynamic viscosity unit, or simply viscosity unit is poise. SI unit is your Pascal into second, Pascal second, or Newton per meter square into second. Then your MKS unit, 1 Newton equal to 1 kg into meter per second square. 1 kg into meter per second square into second by meter square. How much you will get in MKS unit? Kg per meter into second. This one is MKS unit. Then your CGS unit is poise. Poise to Pascal second conversion also important. So we will convert that one. 1 Pascal into second equal to Newton into second by meter square. So 1 Newton equal to 10 to the power 5 dyne by 1 meter square equal to 10 to the power 4 centimeter square into second. Dyne per centimeter square into second equal to your poise. So you will get 10 poise. Then 1 poise equal to 0.1 Newton per meter square into second, or 0.1 Pascal second. This one also important. Next question, the dimensions of the coefficient of dynamic viscosity mu MLT notation system are. So from Newton law, tau is equal to mu du by dy, mu equal to tau into dy by du, velocity gradient is du by dy. So tau is stress, we already know the unit of coefficient of viscosity is Pascal into second or Newton per meter square into second. So Newton, 1 Newton equal to 1 kg into meter per second square. into second divided by meter square. So you will get kg per second into meter or meter into second. So kg is mass m by length is meter l t. So finally what you will get, m to the power 1, l to the power minus 1, t to the power minus 1. So from option we will check d is your correct answer. Which property of mercury is the main reason for use in barometers? High density, negligible capillary effect, low vapor pressure. Yes, C is your correct answer. Next question. In the phenomenon of cavitation, the characteristics fluid property involved is surface tension, viscosity, bulk modulus of elasticity, vapor pressure. Yes, D is your correct answer. Vapor pressure related with cavitation. Next question. If pressure at any point in the liquid approaches the vapor pressure, liquid starts vaporizing and creates pockets or bubbles of dissolved gases and vapor. This phenomenon is this one definition of cavitation. So D is your correct answer. Next question. The increase in pressure of liquid lowers the boiling point. No. Raises the boiling point of liquid. Yes. For this reason only we use pressure cooker in cooking. Next question. In adiabatic process, the heat exchange between system and surrounding. Adiabatic process, Q1 equal to Q2 or dQ equal to 0. Heat transfer is 0. So in this question, heat exchange between system and surrounding. Heat exchange dQ is 0. B is your correct answer. Then next question, which law of thermodynamics is known as law of conservation of energy? First law of thermodynamics. Then next question, the first law of thermodynamics is the law of conservation of energy. C is your correct answer. Question is, the heating of a gas at constant pressure is governed by Boyle's law. In Boyle's law, your temperature is constant, pressure is inversely proportional to volume. And in case of Charles' law, your pressure is constant, volume is directly proportional to temperature. In case of Gay-Lussac law, your volume is constant, pressure is directly proportional to temperature. In case of Joule's law, your internal energy is directly proportional to temperature. So at constant pressure, this one, Charles' law, volume is directly proportional to temperature. Question is, in a steady flow reversible adiabatic process, what done is equal to steady flow process, reversible adiabatic process, and steady flow energy equation per unit mass, it's equal to H1 equal to C1 square by 2 plus GZ1 plus Q, it's equal to H2 plus C2 square by 2 GZ2 plus what done. So reversible adiabatic process. Q equal to 0. If you neglect change in potential energy and change in kinetic energy, if you neglect potential energy, then this term will become 0. And if you neglect kinetic energy, these two will be 0. So W equal to H1 minus H2 or change in enthalpy. What done is equal to change in enthalpy. C is your correct answer. Next question. The gas constant R is equal to Mayer's equation. Mayer's relation Cp minus Cb equal to R. R is gas constant. It's the difference of two specific heats. Cp is specific heat at constant pressure and Cv is specific heat at constant volume. And R is your gas constant, Mayer's relation. Next question, air is compressed isothermally by performing work is equal to 60 kilojoule upon it. The change in internal energy is how much? It's an isothermal process. So T1 equal to T2. The change in internal energy, del U, we have to calculate. So we know del U equal to mc dt. Dt is T1 minus T2 or T2 minus T1, whatever it may be. T1 equal to T2, so dt equal to 0. So del U equal to 0. Isothermal process, internal energy, change in internal energy, 0. U1 equal to U2. B is your correct answer. If they will ask for change in heat transfer, then by performing work, work done is negative, compressed isothermally, so work done is negative, minus 16 kilojoule. dQ equal to minus 16 kilojoule. But in this question, they asked for change in internal energy, this is 0. A system is taken from state A to state B along two different paths, 1 and 2. The heat absorbed and work done by the system along these paths are Q1 and Q2 and W1 and W2 respectively. Then, so from let this on state A, this on state B. Taken from A to state B in two different paths. Let this path is path 1. We'll change the color. Path 2. So in path 1, heat transfer is Q1 and work done is W1, and in path 2, Q2 and W2. And we know internal energy is a point function. So whatever the path you follow, regardless the path you follow, internal energy will remain unchanged. So, first law we will apply in path 1, Q1 equal to dQ equal to del U plus dW. So, Q1 equal to del U1 plus W1. And in path 2, Q2 equal to del U2 plus W2. And we know in both two processes or two paths, final point and initial point are same, and internal energy is a point function, so U1 equal to U2. So finally we will get from here U1 equal to Q1 minus W1, let this one equation 1. Del U2 equal to Q2 minus W2, equation 2. From equation 1 and 2, change in internal energy is same, so Q1 minus W1 equal to Q2 minus W2. D is your correct answer. Next question, in a free expansion of a gas between two equilibrium states, work transfer is free expansion, so work is 0. Expansion against vacuum is called as free expansion, so work done is 0, no work. Examples are tire burst and balloon rupture. These two examples are also very, very important. constant internal energy. If we will take the gas as ideal gas, then T1 equal to T2. In this case, internal energy also, change in internal energy is 0, or U1 equal to U2. Irreversible process, free expansion is irreversible. Work done, change in work done is 0, change in heat transfer also 0. Free expansion process, work transfer. C is your correct answer. A certain gas has Cp value equal to 1968 joule per kg Kelvin and Cb value of 1507 joule per kg Kelvin. The value of R is Mayer's relation. Again we will use Cp minus Cb equal to R. R value we have to calculate. Cp how much? 1968 minus 1507 equal to R. Implies R equal to 461 joule per kg Kelvin. So from option we will check 461 available, but unit is different, kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So you have to be careful. So in kilojoule per kg Kelvin, it will 0.461 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. From option A is your correct answer. This thing you have to careful. You have to check this unit also. Otherwise you will answer D. But correct answer is A. Next question. The steady flow energy equation of a perfect gas flowing through a nozzle with initial and final velocities of V1 and V2 are given by. Steady flow energy equation for a perfect gas through a nozzle. Already discussed, for unit mass H1 equal to H1 plus, instead of C they are writing V. So V1 square by 2 plus GZ1 plus Q equal to H2 plus V2 square by 2 GZ2 plus W1. So it's a nozzle. We used to call as adiabatic nozzle, so heat transfer is 0. Work done also 0. If we will neglect potential energy, then GZ1, GZ2, you have to neglect. Then neglect kinetic energy in case of nozzle, we cannot neglect. So H1 minus H2 equal to V2 square minus V1 square by 2. From option B is your correct answer. It's perfectly insulated, a perfect gas. Actually in nozzle we need to consider it as perfectly insulated. So adiabatic, del Q equal to 0, or change in heat transfer, it's equal to 0. So this is the end of this part.